Good morning and welcome back. This is Burn Rate, and we're playing the Russian campaign in EU4. So last episode I was looking to create a client state down here, but I didn't realize that I can take Oman and everything. I need to be on the same continent to create a client state. So I could kind of do that with all this stuff in Kazan. Once I convert them, I thought I needed to core it, but I could do that with Kazan and then hand these all off to a client state and annex them once they core them themselves, and so I could keep expanding and not really worry about my overexpansion too much. But that's just, I have to wait on the conversion. So down here I thought I could, but I can't. So I'm just going to core these. Where's my coring map mode? Unrest, colonial, tech. Is there a map mode? Trade goods, forts. I don't know, there might be something that makes sense there. Trade, religion map mode. So that's a big mess. Oh, this one needs to be converted too. I'll have to do that next. 6 months, not bad. So yeah. So let me just core all these down here. Because I cannot client state them. Should have been really cool. I think that's it. Yeah, and this little thing touching here, which is pretty. Oh, maybe I can! Oh, I'm not actually touching. Maybe that's why. It's not a different continent. This is still Asia, I believe. I'm stupid. Whatever. It would take too long. I don't want to declare war on Persia or Theodora right now. So Persia is still... Are they westernized? No, they're Muslim and they are 27. So I could easily take them. Russia and Khorasan, it's not really important. So, what happens if I attack Khorasan? Declare war, Persia will join against me. So who am I taking next? Oh, they have military access. So let me take that away. Diplomacy, cancel access. So, let's see. So wait, to send a new guy? So I declare war, no one will join me, no one will join them, that's fine. And I can convert all these things in protectorate. So, and I can add this to protectorate too. So, yeah, I don't really want to fight Persia just right now. I have 3 armies and 1 general, so I'll get 1 more army just in case. What's it called? Scandinavia or the Commonwealth decides to attack or something. So if I attack you, where do you have forts? Where's the map mode? So you have... No, Yarkand is not, but these 2. You can take those 2 pretty quick, probably. I'll just have to watch where your army goes, so I don't have to worry about it. So let's declare war. Imperialism. Let's march straight into your capital. Oh, this is... Let's see if I can get in there. Oh, they got a 1 tick. I should have waited. I didn't realize that was off. Negative 40. What is this? This is a level 6. Can I get down? I can't get down to here. Oh, I could go through Kiva. Huh. Let's do that, just so we can squash their army and take their capital right away. And we don't really have to worry about it. I'll just make them happy for now. I don't really need extra casus belli against everyone. So I feel like... Where's all these guys going? I could bring another army down here to speed this up. I mean, I don't know if I really need to speed it up. Let me just take this one and then I'll just carpet siege the whole thing. I mean, that was fast. The siege is already over. I don't know why this is negative 42. It seems like too much. Uh-oh. Turn this on and this on. That should restrict them. And we'll just take a few guys out. Go start cleaning that. More conversions, very good. Oh, I wanted to do Kolmgori. Well, that'll be almost done soon. So you're converted. Oh, I'm at war, so I can't client state them. So that'll be neat to do, though. So this is taking a while. God, people taking my provinces already. Not cool. So yeah, you take back Kolmgori. They took Kiva, which is annoying. Let's go. Where are you guys headed? Let's go get rid of that. Wasting my time. So I can abolish serfdom. Tsar Alexander I's liberal legislation. Can abolish serfdom and lose 2 stability. Stability cost modifier goes up, morale of army goes up, infantry cost goes up, technology cost goes down, and fight 16 noble regiments. Or I could gain. Okay, that's easy. 11 peasant regiments rise up in revolt in Tcheretsk. So, Tcheretsk. Right there. Bring this guy down. And oh, this guy's being super annoying. Oh, what is this? National Bank. Lose 5 inflation, gain stability. Lose 5 inflation, gain stability. Bank loans. It's basically just how big bank loans will be. Sure. These guys, no, they're not in the province yet. Excellent, we've won this. So you go there. And you can go here and here. There. You can go down here. So that'll spread that out. And I think someone's already going there, maybe? Doesn't matter. So we have all of these and that, and I think that's everything. Revolt. Oh, that's, what just happened? Did my leader die again? I should pay better attention. I should have waited for that bank event until after that fired. Or no, it went with the other one. Dang, I didn't pay attention. I can tech up military. See where I have. Oh no, it did go with that one, okay. Because I don't have the 10% on the military tech. Look at that, improved flanking range, 25%, land morale, military tactics, mass infantry. That's cool. And my admin advisor is dead, so I'll take... Do I have any... I don't think I have any inflation right now, yeah, after that event. Prestige, that's nice. I'll cause decay a little slower. 17 monthly. Now I'll just go with the cheap guy, just for that extra admin point. Gather everyone together down here. Oh, I have to take Shiva back. Forgot. Oh, my vassal did. Nice vassal. Alright, let's do more. Ashabad. Where's that at? They have right here, they have religious zeal. Okay. So we're at war still. 100%, no, not 100% war score. Oh, because you exist. Can't get over here. Diplomacy. Ask for military access. So kind. Totally miss this province. It's all broken apart. I guess I don't think I'll take that one. Just won't have to deal with it. Cool. So, peace. Take these. Excellent. Alright, so take money. War reparations is kind of wasteful because we can get some prestige from that. It's outstanding. Not Kokand. Because war reparations, that's fine. That's exactly what I want. Send demand. Now let's see what my overextension is. My overextension is dangerously high, 106%. Oh, yes. Assign province to a client state. We'll just do that. We'll make it. Can make them their local dynasty. Why not? Now I'll make it my dynasty. Cool. That's a good enough emblem. White line. Great. Enjoy. So we can give you. What? Wait. You're not converted yet. You're almost converted. You are a core. No, this is make. This is. Okay. I want to core these guys. So I can assign this whole big pile here to the client state, and then I won't have to deal with it. I think that'll be good. I just need to work on. So these are all coring down here. And all this. Oh, it attaches. So I don't even need to core this. So I can just attach it. I just need to finish converting it. Let's do that. We've gained a casus belli against. Why? That doesn't make sense. So you become. You convert. You're converted. Let's do this in order as best as we can. We have five diplomatic. Oh, because we have military access here still. So we have forces inside their borders. Get out. Alright, cancel, send. Alright. Now. Unrest like crazy all over the place. Haha, royal marriage with them. That's cool. So they're converting there. This is converting, this is converting. This tiny little thing needs to be converted. So everything that borders them needs to be converted right now. Or is being converted. My overextension is still dangerously high. 97%. Causing all sorts of fun things in my country. Could get this. It wouldn't be bad. Wouldn't be good. Wouldn't be bad. Let's do it. Rifle. Look at that. Infantry fire +1. Cavalry shock +1. Supply limit. Superior unit type. Mass infantry. Alright. So my overextension will drop rapidly. All these are coring. And as these convert, I can hand them over. So that I can... What I want to do next is... I think just grab... I could grab Afghanistan. Let's see. I have a truce because I fought them at that war with Kazan. When does that end? 3 years. Oh, that's not bad. You and your dumb alliance with Ming should fight Portugal. They're at war with a bunch of people over here. See, that'd be interesting. Because let's see if I could declare war. Tuscany, New Portugal, and Spain. New Portugal. And Spain would join. I wouldn't really like that. Tuscany would come through the Commonwealth. And they're pretty serious. They're not Italy. But Spain, like a lot of forces would come from over here, so I really couldn't totally commit myself to Portugal. Although, what is Portugal's forces? Oh, they're pretty big. Ah, they're not crazy, but I think with Spain and Tuscany, it'll be more annoying than it's worth. So I'll just wait a couple years, take Afghanistan. You can watch my overextension drop like a rock. Oop, where is they? Kind of far away from them. They're gonna get their years of separatism, unfortunately. That's fine. Is there anything else at like 90? Krasnovodsk, Ashabad. So these ones. Where's Ashabad? That was one of these. Oh, is that over here? No. Where's Ashabad? I thought I knew where that was. Oh, it's right here. So let's bring another unit down. Just so we can avoid some separatism. I can get my Diplotech to 30. Let's do that. And our Admin Tech 2. Achievement unlocked! This Navy can take it all. I don't know if you guys can see that. I don't think so. You can't see any of my Steam stuff the way it's recording. But gain at least 7 naval morale. I cannot... Is that really... Wow. Let's take a look at this. All the times I guess I'm not very good with the Navy. I guess I've never had 7 naval morale. That's a little embarrassing. But I never really play with the Navy much. I kind of avoid it. So yeah. Achievement unlocked. Gain 7 naval morale. I'll help out Theodoro here. They seem to be having some problems. They're my allies, so let me in. Military access from Scandinavia. Are they at war? Yes, with Ottomans, Morocco, and Milan. Probably because the Commonwealth is too. Yeah. It's time for their yearly war with them. So let's speed up time again. Spare no expense. Gain 50 Emin power. It sounds good. We'll go for our tech. Production efficiency. At 30. We're in 6th place. We ranked up. Cool. I wasn't really expecting. Who's getting the most this month? Ming is doing great. France, Great Britain, Commonwealth. I'm still behind Scandinavia and the Commonwealth. Painful. So... Placement. There we go. Stuck. Behind Great Britain, Ottomans. Still behind the Ottomans? Interesting. I guess they had a big, huge start on me for a long time. Most of the early game. I had a lot of problems. But, you know, things happen. So, this is about to rebel. We're about to finish coring some stuff. My overextension is down to 93. And I took care of that. Austria has declared war on Pomerania. Interesting. I lost a lot of guys there. That's pretty brutal. Let me help out Commonwealth is coming down to fight the Ottomans. I should have not given Scandinavia military access. Because then they wouldn't have been able to help. Can I revoke it? Haha. I mean, they're probably already through, but they wouldn't have been able to help the Commonwealth as easily. So we converted a bunch. Record some over. I record all those one over here. So we had overextension of 96 something percent. Now it's 69.5. And these are. This is still not converted. This isn't converted either. We'll do this one. What did I just convert? I was converting stuff all over the place instead of in the proper order. It's okay. A couple more years and our truce with Afghanistan will be over. No, Tuscany. What about these guys? Declare war. Bahamanas. Will join. You should go to war with Ming. You should. Is Portugal still at war? Yeah. I mean, if these guys get totally drained, I might attack them again. One last try. Tuscany, Holland, and the Commonwealth. So Tuscany is kind of big. But let me see. I don't think Holland will be a problem. Let me check. Let's go back to armies. Put it in order by name. Ah, it's spazzing out. Holland. 20,000. They're over their force limit. Whatever. The Commonwealth is just nuts. So the Commonwealth has 217. They have a lot of men and manpower right now. Scandinavia's not nearly as big. Wish we could do something. Support rebels. So I could do 4 unrest. The big spenders. It's the best I could do. Bulgarian separatists. That's not really worth it. Let me see. I should hire another army. And I have no generals still, but I don't need them right now. Super unnecessary. Continue on with our religious crusade. Make everything in the Russian Orthodox Church. Outstanding. So why? You can only add provinces on the European continent, so this is off the continent. So I might have been right down here. No, that's the Holy Roman Empire. What am I thinking? So, I am not very smart. So I can't add this because this isn't touching me. Or no, it's touching them. That's what the requirement is. Is it because they have unrest? It's touching their borders. Is it because it's not touching my borders? And I gave them this stupid place first. Did not. That's dumb, I think. If that's how it works, if that's what it's doing, as far as I can tell, that is what it's doing. And I can't core it. Return this province to Nogai. Lose 10 prestige, not important. Return this province to Kiva. Lose 10 prestige, not really important, I have a bunch. Interesting. That is weird. That's very annoying. At least I realized it here before I cut off the whole bottom half or something. I'll just return. I'll wait till that converts and then return both of those. And now we have imperialism cast a spell against them. So if they get a claim, if these guys fabricate a claim on them, I can declare war and take it back. That's kind of ridiculous. Like, you should be able to. And they immediately have some kind of uprising. Well, whatever. Look and let the rebellion run its course. I'm helping Theodoro siege their thing back over here. They were a big mess for a while. Still nowhere near my force limit. 287. So 107 more. So, well, I'm going to take a break here. Next time we can increase our Nizhny Ambinsk. I don't know what it's called. Again. What are these? Client state, that's the word. It's not a vassal. So... but they are like a vassal. Where does it have these? Guaranteeing Riga. Yeah, it is a vassal. It's listed as a vassal, but it's a client state. But it basically acts exactly like a vassal. So if these guys fabricate on them, I can attack them and just feed them that, and then I don't have to worry about it. So that'll be neat. Alright, well, thanks for watching. I'm going to take a break, and I'll see you guys in the next episode.